गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस चैप्टर 8, सेल स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शन. दिस इज योर लेक्चर 3 फॉर सब्जेक्ट साइंस फॉर क्लास 8. इन द एंड आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस होमवर्क सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ लेक्चर 2, द क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आई गेव यू यस्टरडे. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द लेक्चर. First of all, what are the topics that we are going to discuss today? The topics are cell structure and function and parts of the cell. Cell structure and function. Each organ in the living organism performs different functions, such as digestion. Digestion is being performed by different organs like liver, intestine, etc. Assimilation and absorption. So assimilation and absorption is again done by different glands, or you can say different organs. Similarly, different organs of a plant perform particular specialized function. So in plant also there are different organs, and those different organs will perform particular specialized functions. For example, roots help in the absorption of water and minerals. Like roots is a part of plant, right? So what is the role of roots? Roots help in absorption of water and minerals, and they take water and minerals from the soil and provide to the other parts of the plant. Next is, each organ is further made up of smaller parts called tissue. So when we say cell will make tissue, and what are tissue? Tissues are group of cells, okay, that have similar structure and they perform similar function. So in structure they are same and they are in group and they are performing similar function also. So those are tissue. So organ are made up of tissues, okay. A tissue is group of similar type cells performing a particular function, because cell is making tissue and tissue is making the organ. Fine. Now we will talk about plant cell. So in front of you, this is the plant cell, okay. Plant cell has a cell wall, that is the outer layer of plant cell, and then in the inner layer there is a cell membrane. Then the matrix, this matrix is known as cytoplasm, okay. There is a vacuole, this is chloroplast, this is Golgi body. This part is known as endoplasmic reticulum, and this is known as mitochondria, and this is the nucleus, and this is the nuclear envelope. Okay, so this is a complete plant cell. Let's discuss about cell part and their function. So in the left hand side there are cell parts written, and on the right hand side there are the functions of cell part is written. We will start with cell membrane. Cell membrane controls what enters and leaves the cell. So cell membrane acts as a semi-permeable membrane, or you can as it is acting like a border system, because it will control the entry and the leaving of the contents inside the cell. Okay, what is going to get enter in the cell and what is going to leave the cell, that all thing will be managed by cell membrane, or will be decided by cell membrane. Fine. Now what is nuclear membrane? Nuclear membrane is having a same function like cell membrane, but nuclear membrane is actually controlling entry and leaving of the nucleus. what is going to enter the nucleus, what is going to leave the nucleus, that will be controlled by nuclear membrane. And nuclear membrane will be covering the nucleus as cell membrane is covering the cell. Then what is nucleus? Nucleus control the center of the cell. Means this is the control center of the cell. Like in computer, CPU is the brain of the computer, right? Similarly, nucleus is the brain of the cell. Okay, it is controlling everything of the cell. Okay, nucleus is the brain of the cell, or you can say control center of the cell. Nucleus contains chromosomes. Chromosomes are thread-like structures, thin thread-like structures. They are in coiled form and they are present inside the nucleus. They contain DNA. DNA contains the genes. So basically, chromosomes contain the genetic information in the nucleus. So by chromosome, by genes, this is getting transferred from parents to the offsprings. Okay, from parents to the child. Then what is endoplasmic reticulum? Endoplasmic reticulum is covered over the nucleus and they are the transport system in the cell. They are acting as a transport system. Then ribosome. Ribosomes are the cell organelles which make proteins. They are the protein factories. They do the protein synthesis. Golgi body. Golgi body are organelles. They pack the protein. They are packaging unit, okay, of the cell. Then vacuole. Vacuole are actually present in plants also, animals also. But in plants, the size of vacuoles is very big. And in animals, the size of vacuole is comparatively small. Okay, so they store the water and food inside it. And waste also. Lysosome. They break down the old cell parts. Okay, and mitochondria, they are they are actually giving energy to the cellular respiration. They provide energy. Mitochondria is also known as powerhouse of the cell because it provides energy in the form of ATP. So these all are the function of the cell parts, and these are the function of the cell parts. Now this is an animal cell. There is cell membrane, Golgi body, vacuole, small vacuole you can see. In plant there is a big vacuole, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, cytoplasm, nucleus, nuclear envelope, rough endoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria, lysosome and ribosomes. Okay, so now we are going to see the difference between plant and animal cell together. So this is plant versus animal cell. Both of them has a cell membrane, right? Both of them have a nucleus and a nucleolus. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum and rough endoplasmic reticulums are present in both. Why the name smooth and rough is given for endoplasmic reticulum? In rough endoplasmic reticulum, you can see small circle-like things are there over here. So these are ribosomes. And because of ribosomes, this surface becomes rough. But when we talk about smooth, they do not have it. So this is the smooth surface. Fine. So there is a big vacuole in plant cell, as you can see. And in animal cell, the vacuole is comparatively very small. Mitochondria are present in animals and plants both because they are the powerhouse of the cell. They provide energy in the form of ATP. Golgi apparatus are also present in both of the plant and animal cell. Chloroplasts are only present in plants because these are required for photosynthesis. As you know, plants do photosynthesis. So they provide a green pigment known as chlorophyll. Okay, they are the part of the plastids. And animal cells do not have a chloroplast because they do not do photosynthesis as they are heterotrophic. Cell wall is again a feature of the plant cell. Animal cell do not have a cell wall. Okay. And lysosomes. Okay. So we are going to learn about in detail what is cell wall, what is cell membrane in the upcoming slides. Now we will talk about parts of the cell. The basic components of a cell are cell membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus. So we are going to talk about cell membrane first. The cytoplasm and the nucleus are enclosed within the cell membrane. So the cytoplasm and the nucleus are enclosed within the cell membrane, also called the plasma membrane. सेल मेम्ब्रेन इज ऑल्सो नोन एज प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन. इफ समवन से प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन एंड सेल मेम्ब्रेन, दैट मीन्स दैट इज द वन ऑफ द सेम थिंग. इट इज लिविंग पार्ट ऑफ द सेल, दिस पार्ट इज लिविंग, ओके, एंड इट इज थिन एंड डेलिकेट एंड इलास्टिक. सो इट इज थिन, डेलिकेट एंड इलास्टिक, एंड इट इज अ लिविंग पार्ट ऑफ द सेल, ओके, सेल मेम्ब्रेन. दिस मेम्ब्रेन सेपरेट सेल फ्रॉम वन अनदर एंड ऑल्सो द सेल फ्रॉम द सराउंडिंग मीडियम. सो दिस मेम्ब्रेन इज डूइंग वॉट, दीज आर गोइंग टू सेपरेट द सेल्स फ्रॉम ईच अदर ऑल्सो, एंड इट इज गोइंग टू सेपरेट द सेल फ्रॉम द सराउंडिंग मीडियम एज वेल. It is a selectively permeable membrane, okay? It allows the flow of limited substance in and out of the cell. So it is selectively permeable, means it will allow to substance to enter inside in a limited form. For example, someone is coming inside your class, okay? That student will say, may I come in, right? If that student belongs to the class and have something very useful for you, or it is logical, then only the teacher will permit that student to come inside. Otherwise, that student will not come inside, right? So that, like, the door is acting like a membrane for allowing and not allowing the people to come inside the class or the house. Similarly, cell membrane also does the same function, okay? And this gives shape to the cell, and it gives shape also to the cell. Otherwise, cell must be shapeless. Cytoplasm is a liquid matrix. It would have come out from the cell. So it is giving a shape to the cell as well. In addition to cell membrane, an outer thick layer in cell of plants called cell wall. With cell membrane, plants has a thick layer known as cell wall. This is an additional thick layer which is present only in plants and bacteria. Okay? This additional cell wall surrounding the cell membrane is required by the plants for protection against variations. Okay? So this additional cell wall is surrounding the cell membrane is required by the plant for the protection. Okay? Against the variation which is going on in and out there. Like variations in temperature, high wind speed, atmospheric moisture, etc. Okay, so these kind of variations could be faced by the plants because they are outside the environment. They do not have any shelter. In fact, they are providing shelter to others. So they are exposed to these variations because they cannot move. They are immovable. Fine, you can move. I can move. Animals can move. But what about plants? They cannot move. They are non-motile. And cells can be observed in a leaf peel of a poppy, onion, etc. This poppy one I have given you as an activity also. Okay. So onion peel, you can see, you can take out an onion peel. You can see the onion cell. You can see the cell wall, nucleus, cytoplasm, vacuole. And this is be clear under a microscope, and this experiment surely we will do as soon as school will get open. Now we will talk about cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is the jelly-like substance present between the cell membrane and the nucleus. So cytoplasm is what? It is a jelly-like substance. Okay? Present between the cell membrane and the nucleus. I hope you understand what is jelly. It's neither a liquid nor a solid, it's a semi-solid. Fine. Cytoplasm is the medium where all other cellular components are suspended. So this is cytoplasm. This is a medium where all other cellular components are getting suspended. Can you see this endoplasmic reticulum is suspended here? Mitochondria also, nucleus also. Or this Golgi apparatus also. Everything is being suspended in this cytoplasm. So it is acting like a matrix. Okay. It is a medium. It's a jelly-like substance. It's a matrix. And it suspends all the cellular components inside it. Various other components of organelles of cell are present in the cytoplasm, like mitochondria, Golgi bodies, ribosomes. We have discussed about mitochondria. It is powerhouse of the cell. Golgi body, packaging unit of the cell. Ribosomes, synthesis of protein is being done in ribosomes. So these components, these various components which are present inside the cytoplasm, they are known as cell organelles. Okay, they are present inside the cell. They are part of the cell. So these components are present inside the cytoplasm. Homework is, you need to do NCERT questions. Okay, question number 6. State the difference between eukaryotes and prokaryotes. We have already discussed prokaryotes and eukaryotes. So you need to write the difference between prokaryotes and eukaryotes in a tabular form in your FAIR notebook. Okay, next question is, cells are the basic structural units of living organisms. Explain. So you need to explain that why the cell is a basic structural unit of living organism. Okay, you need to explain it briefly. And this question also you are going to do in your FAIR notebook for today. Now we will talk about homework solutions of lecture 1. Fine. Indicate whether the following statements are true or false. You just need to tell what is true and what is false. Fine. Unicellular organisms have one cell body. So I told you that day, yesterday, that unicellular organisms are the organism which have only one cell and they perform all their function through that one cell only. Either it's respiration, digestion, excretion, engulfing of food, reproduction, anything if they want to do, they will do from one single cell only. So this statement is very much true. Next is, muscle cells are branched. So you have seen the diagram of muscle cells. So it was looking like a branched cell. No, they are not branched. Nerve cells are branched, right? So this is false. Next is, the basic living unit of an organism is an organ. I told you that cell will make tissue, tissue will make organ, organ will make the organ system will make an organism. So how come the basic living unit can be an organ? It will be a cell. So this is again false. Amoeba has an irregular shape. Yesterday I showed you the picture of amoeba also. And it was looking irregular in shape, right? So yes, this is true. This statement is true. Now next question was, make a sketch of the human nerve cell. Human nerve cell has another name which is known as neuron. What function do the nerve cells perform? This we have discussed. Today I will be discussing this with you again. Okay, as I have given this in a question, in the form of a question. So the answer is, you can see this diagram. This is the cell body and this is the axon. And these are the axon terminal branches, which is also known as axon bulb. So let's discuss about each and every part in detail. The cell body is the cell's life support center. Here the cell is there, the life support center is there inside the cell. These parts are known as dendrites. They receive message from other cells because there are millions of nerve cells like this. Okay, then this part is known as axon. Axon passes message away from the cell body to other neurons, muscles or glands. Fine, this is the function of axon. Then this is neural impulse. It is giving the electrical signal traveling from down from axon to here, to the branches. Now these are the terminal branches of axon, also known as axon bulbs, because they are looking like a bulb here. These form junctions with other cells. They are going to form the junction, means they are going to join the other cell from here. Okay, and this is myelin sheath, covers the axon of some neurons and helps speed neural impulses. So this is myelin sheath. Okay, so this is the complete structure of a neuron, and many neurons are attached with this one and with the branches end also. Okay, so this is one single cell of the nerve. and this is also known as neuron, or you can say nerve cell. This is the structural and functional unit of a nervous system. Okay. Now, the main function of the nerve cell is to transmit messages to the brain from receptor organs and vice versa. So, this is the main function of nerve cell. It will transmit messages to the brain from the receptor organs and then from receptor organs back to the brain, vice versa. Okay, means brain from receptor organs and receptor organs to brain. It has control over the working of different parts of the body. Okay, and it has a control over the working of different parts of the body because it gives the signal to different from the different parts of the body to the brain and from the brain to different part of the body. So this is the main function of nerve cell. That's all for today. Thank you.